Nicholas, I'm going to be speaking to you with my mind on this one. It's a little trick I picked up from a witch. I ended up watching a lot of Bob Ross, so I tried to figure out how to emulate his mountain painting. And while I was figuring that out, I saw these little skips. Sure, it has to do with the positive and negative charges on the blanket and on the tent spike. Sometimes they pick up, sometimes they leave behind. I was going to talk about my YouTube viewing history. Everything was Cinemassacre. Angry video game nerd. And after I watched everything on that channel, moved on to General Marvels, Hannah Hart, Epic Mealtime, others. And then I got to Cracked. They're kind of like College Humor's doppelganger on YouTube. It's a lot of the same kind of skits. Parodies and whatnot. ASMR parody. It's pretty old. This was about 4 months ago, and I think the video was 2 years old or something like that. So yeah, they're pretty ahead of the curve. And after I saw that parody, I ended up looking it up, of course. I came across was the one Lilium. The first artist to trigger me to. She told a lot of stories about childhood, and that took me right back to mine. She was too young for me to even watch. She seemed like 16 or something. I don't know. Something about the thumbnails. watched was the Binaural tuning fork, sonic massage, or something like that. And it knocked me completely out. Literally, like, I think I fell asleep the first 5 minutes of that video. And then I woke up just in time to hear her say, "Sleep well." And that shocked me. It kind of really resonated because I wrote a song called "Sleep Well" a long time ago. Probably 10 years ago. And I don't know, from then on, I was watching everything Heather Feather's done. I haven't watched it all yet, but I've probably made it at least 60% of the way. I started watching more, probably about 3 or 4 hours a night. And did that for a good, probably 2 weeks. Seeing gentle whispering pick up in the list at the bottom. So, of course, I ended up checking her out. Much like the one Lillian. Beautiful accent. Very animated, expressive face. Had an extreme subtlety to them. Crinkle, crinkle, little shirts was the first video I saw. The first one, the red shirt in the thumbnail, I think. And then I realized they were in Russian too, some of them. And that was amazing. So when Crinkle Crinkle Little Shirts 2 came out, I started making a habit of watching the Russian ones first. That way I had no idea what she was saying. Still get triggered from it though, of course. And then when I watched the English version and knew what she was actually saying, I had the memories of those triggers where I didn't know. Mixed with the triggers I was getting then. Right after that, though. I'd decided I was going to do it anyway. But that really kind of boosted my happiness level. Made me want to do it right then. Shocked me at first because I realized some of our videos have loops in them, but they're really good loops. So no harm, no foul. After Diana Do, I believe I got into Art for Nila for a little while. She's magic. She plays guitar very well, too. I only heard her play one song, but it was impressive. Not exactly an easy song. She has like 600 something videos. I was like, holy shit. This is a pro. And then watching her videos, I came across her medic kit. She's pretty young, 24, I think. But yeah, probably never would have watched her videos if it wasn't for Minxlaurel 123. They should really have their own channel for their witch collaborations. It'd be awesome. I'd subscribe. Since then, it's pretty much exploded. I can't watch a single artist anymore like I used to. There's just too many. There'd be no way to choose. I do well to just choose one video at a time. artists. Pretty awesome. Darkling Star. She should have a lot of views. She has an entire series with characters, and she's actually really putting a lot of creative energy into it. It really shows. They're short, but kind of concentrates the content. It's really funny. I've genuinely laughed very loud at the skateboard video in particular, and the kush ball. Very funny. Not funny in a comical way, just, I don't know, it's exhilarating, I guess, to see the character so happy. It's pretty neat. used to have some OCD tendencies. Four was, of course, my best friend. But three would eventually become my best friend. like artists not talk about them.